Welcome to our medical channel. In today's video, we dive into the fascinating world of regenerative medicine, focusing on a groundbreaking treatment for optic nerve damage using induced pluripotent stem cells, iPSCs. Have you ever wondered how a damage to the optic nerve can impact our vision? Picture the optic nerve as a vast superhighway, transporting over a million nerve fibers, like cars, carrying critical visual information from the eye to the brain. Now, imagine if an accident, such as glaucoma, trauma, or an ischemic or inflammatory disease, disrupts this highway. That's what happens when the optic nerve gets damaged. The result? Our vision suffers, and in some cases, we may even lose it completely. The tricky part is, unlike other highways, we can't just rebuild this one easily. Nerve fibers in the central nervous system, including the optic nerve, don't regenerate on their own. This makes the optic nerve a difficult patient, resistant to most treatments. Given this, what if there was a way to repair this critical nerve? Enter the world of induced pluripotent stem cells, or iPSCs. These are not your average cells. They're engineered from adult somatic cells, like those from your skin or blood. But here's the twist. These cells are reprogrammed back into an embryonic-like pluripotent state. This transformative process allows them to become almost any type of cell in the body. Yes, you heard right, any type. So how does this transformation occur? It involves introducing specific genes that maintain the properties of embryonic stem cells. These genes are typically delivered using viral vectors. But don't worry, newer techniques involving non-viral delivery methods have been developed to enhance safety and efficiency. Once reprogrammed, these iPSCs exhibit similar characteristics to embryonic stem cells. They can proliferate indefinitely, meaning they can keep dividing and producing more cells. And remember that ability to become any cell type? That's called differentiation, and it's a key feature of these versatile cells. Now, why are we so excited about iPSCs? It's their potential in regenerative medicine. Damage to tissues and organs like the optic nerve can be devastating. But with iPSCs, we have the potential to regenerate these tissues by creating the exact type of cells needed for repair. And the best part? Since iPSCs are derived from the patient's own cells, they can be customized to each individual, reducing the risk of immune rejection and increasing the treatment's efficacy. With these abilities, iPSCs present a unique potential for regenerative medicine. Now imagine the potential of these iPSCs in treating optic nerve damage. The versatility and ethical ease of iPSCs make their potential in treating optic nerve damage particularly compelling. First, let's consider neuronal differentiation. iPSCs can be induced to differentiate into retinal ganglion cells. These are the neurons that make up the optic nerve, transmitting visual information from the eye to the brain. By replacing lost or damaged retinal ganglion cells, iPSCs could restore this critical pathway. But iPSCs can do more than just replace damaged cells. They can be engineered to produce various growth factors that offer protection to existing neurons. These neuroprotective factors promote the survival and regeneration of injured nerve cells. And here's another exciting aspect: customization and personalization. Since iPSCs are derived from the patient's own cells, they can be customized for each individual. This approach could potentially reduce the risk of immune rejection and increase the efficacy of the treatment. Think about the implications of this. A patient could receive a treatment tailor-made for their specific condition, with cells engineered to replace damaged nerves, secrete protective factors, and perfectly match their own biological makeup. With these unique attributes, iPSCs could significantly advance the treatment of optic nerve damage, offering new hope to patients who previously had limited options. This is how iPSCs can revolutionize the treatment for optic nerve damage. But how does this stem cell therapy work? Let's break it down. It all starts with the harvesting of stem cells. These can be taken from the patient or a donor. The harvested cells are then taken to a lab where they undergo a process that multiplies their numbers. This is a crucial step because it ensures that there are enough stem cells to have a significant impact once they are implanted. Once a sufficient number of stem cells have been produced, they are ready for implantation. The cells are strategically placed in or around the damaged areas of the optic nerve. Here, they get to work in three major ways. They can replace the damaged nerve cells, release protective factors that help the surviving nerve cells repair and function more effectively, and create a more conducive environment for nerve regeneration. This is the innovative process of stem cell therapy, a potential game changer for treating optic nerve damage. As we wrap up today's discussion on the revolutionary potential of induced pluripotent stem cells, iPSCs, for treating optic nerve damage, it's clear that we are standing on the brink of a major breakthrough in medical science. With ongoing research in countries like Slovakia, Germany, Austria, and the Czech Republic, Europe is at the forefront of exploring how these versatile cells can be used to restore vision and improve lives. The journey from laboratory research to clinical application is complex and filled with challenges, but the promise of iPSCs gives hope to millions suffering from vision impairment. Stay tuned to our channel for more updates as this exciting field continues to evolve, and thank you for joining us in exploring the future of medicine. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video to help spread awareness about the incredible advancements in regenerative medicine. Stay healthy. We look forward to seeing you in our next video.